Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A recent NASA press release describes the so-called direct observation of a process called magnetic reconnection, a total of four spacecraft, which NASA calls the Magnetospheric Multiscale, have made several thousand trips through Earth's magnetic field. In a new scientific paper, mission scientists report the first observation inside a so-called magnetic reconnection event. The NASA report states, when two sets of magnetic fields connect, an explosive reaction occurs. As the magnetic fields realign and snap into a new formation, they send particles zooming off in jets. The research shows that magnetic reconnection is dominated by the physics of electrons, thus providing crucial information about what powers this fundamental process in nature. But is mainstream solar physics and astronomy correct in its interpretations of the so-called magnetic reconnection process? In this episode, we begin a series of space news reports on this topic with a presentation by Bishop Nicholas Sykes, who describes the theoretical foundations for alternatives to be found in the electric universe.
A concept that has gained increasing acceptance in current physics is the idea of magnetic reconnection, which was referred to at the end of my last Thunderbolts project video. This idea is typically pulled out for service to explain observations of energetic outbursts that are otherwise not explained in a universe or a solar system or a geosphere that is presumed to be electrically neutral, or whose underlying electrical nature is either not acknowledged or assumed not to be important to the phenomena being described. The aurora borealis and aurora australis, northern and southern lights, have accordingly been treated as magnetic reconnection phenomena fairly routinely, and the same idea is applied to kinetic and thermal energy outbursts and particle accelerations that occur variously in the Sun, in the galaxy, and elsewhere in the cosmos. Magnetic reconnection is conceptualized, as its name suggests, as a phenomenon of magnetism, and among other things, it is a way of concealing or ignoring the electrical origin of all magnetism and all magnetic phenomena. It hypothesizes that a magnetic field, such as exists around the Earth, may, under certain conditions, release energy explosively by a spontaneous reconfiguration of the lines of force with which it is visualized. This is affected, so the idea goes, by some of the lines of force breaking and then joining up with different lines of force, thus producing a magnetic field pattern that stores less energy. The energy difference between the two patterns is manifested by conversion to the energy outburst requiring to be explained. It is extraordinary, to say the least, that such an idea has gained so much support in the halls of academia. Electrical engineers and plasma cosmologists have been known to say that magnetic reconnection is one of the stupidest theoretical ideas that researchers have ever derived from the mistaken belief that there are no significant electric currents in space. Yes, the mathematics can perhaps be made to fit with the energy needs involved, but it should be remembered that processes of physics are not explained by such equations. However, in the case of magnetic reconnection, there is a much deeper difficulty than that. I refer to the inconvenient truth that the lines of force of a magnetic field do not physically exist at all. They are a mental aid for us to conceptualize the shape and intensity of a magnetic field. Schoolchildren will agree that when iron filings are sprinkled on a tabletop upon which a bar magnet has been positioned, many of the filings join up into curved lines, but lines of force can just as easily be thought of as between those lines as in any of the lines of filings themselves. Lines of magnetic force are not physical entities, any more than are the contours of a geographer's map or the isobars of a weatherman's chart. One might just as well talk about a contour reconnection as being the explanation of a volcanic eruption, or an isobar reconnection as being the explanation of hurricane energy, as to consider magnetic reconnection to be any reasonable explanation of the energy outbursts concerned. Magnetic reconnection, like a number of other currently popular hypotheses, is a resort of those desperately attempting to shore up a physical model of the universe that largely ignores the role of electricity. Yet where would any magnetic field come from in the first place without electric current? Previous videos in this series have referred to Sir John Herschel's 19th century insight that there are cosmical electric currents traversing space and finding in the upper regions of the sun's atmosphere matter in a fit state of tenuity to be auroralized by them. The electric universe paradigm holds Herschel to have been correct, as was Christian Birkeland, 1867 to 1913, when he posited that the whole of space is filled with electrons and flying electric ions of all kinds, and that the greater part of the material masses in the universe is found not in the solar systems or nebulae, but in empty space. In other words, Birkeland proposed that space consisted everywhere of plasma. Modern estimates indeed consider that more than 99.9% of the mass of the universe resides in the plasma. Let us therefore spend a little time here on the topic of plasma. The ancients discerned four elements of earth, water, air, and fire. It is likely that they were describing the same reality as we now do when we speak of the four states of solid, liquid, gas, and plasma. The idea of plasma was suggested by the various forms of electric discharge that take place through what we have been accustomed to call ionized gases. The forms of this electrical discharge and certain of their properties brought to mind the properties of blood plasma in living beings, and so the name plasma has stuck for the state of matter in which the discharges can occur. Dr. Donald Scott points out that the last state of matter to be identified in modern times, the plasma, is really to be understood to be the first rather than the fourth state of matter. For one thing, nearly all of the matter of the universe is in this form, as Birkeland proposed. The galaxies, stars, and planets are, comparatively speaking, specks of dirt and dust in a sea of plasma. When an electrical potential difference is initiated across a length of gas at low pressure, in a laboratory, or for that matter in a fluorescent light at home, certain changes take place that transform much of the gas into a state of plasma, because the atoms of the gas are being broken into their subatomic constituents. Unfortunately, cosmologists in general seem not to be able to connect even the most elementary knowledge about the behavior of electrified plasma to the observations of their own field. Clear evidence of plasma in space, for example, is misleadingly interpreted or visualized as streams of gravitationally driven gases, the solar wind being perhaps the most well-known example. But contrasting with this, fundamental to an understanding of the workings of the electrical universe, is a basic knowledge gained from the electric discharge laboratory of how a body of plasma reacts to electrical stress.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.